dropped another sweet video. Today I'm going to tell you how to make sweet chocolate flapjacks. These are very nice, sugar-free chocolate delights. They're amazing. For this recipe, because I'm going to do such a large tray of them, I'm going to be using 400 grams of organic oats, 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon, 3 whole organic ripe bananas, which I have mashed up here to this sort of consistency, so I'll show you that in a minute. On the stove, I've been melting 200 grams of organic butter. In that, I've also put 50 grams of Montezuma's 100% chocolate bar, which you can get in Sainsbury's. This is incredible and cheap, and it tastes fantastic. There's 2 ways of adding the chocolate to this recipe. The one I've done at the moment is to add it into the butter and melt it, because it just makes it a bit easier for the recipe, really. And I've added 50 drops of Shriek to this recipe, because it's quite a large one, and I'm using such a dark chocolate, sometimes you might need a few more extra drops to stop it being too bitter. Your preference, though. Before I get started, if you could like and share this recipe video, that'd be fantastic. And if you haven't liked our page already, please do so, that'd be great. In here, I've got 400 grams of oats, as I said. I'm now going to add in 2 full teaspoons of ground cinnamon. And I'm going to stir that in, make sure it's mixed in with the oats quite well. That's quite a lot of flavour when you add the cinnamon to these. Now I'm going to add my chocolate and butter. Now you can just pour this straight in, no problems. This is how I'm adding it. I'm adding the chocolate now, and it's fully melted. But there is another way to do this. So just stir this in. Make sure that the butter and the chocolate has coated all of your oats. It starts to come together. Yeah, nice oaty chocolatey mess. Once you've done that and it's coated the oats, if you haven't put your chocolate in to the butter and melted it with it, then you would pour your butter in with the sweet and you coat all your oats, and then what you do is you add your bananas. So I'm going to add my bananas now. So that's three mashed bananas, quite well mashed. This is what holds the flapjacks together. You won't really taste the bananas in this. And then mix that in quite nicely. It'll come together. It doesn't take, this is a fairly short recipe, and you can use the ingredients in your kitchen already. I'd say, obviously, I recommend organic with everything. Organic, the word itself should exist, but everything should be organic standard. But you don't have to. That's nicely mixed in now. You've got a big, almost like a dough mixture. And then I'm going to put that into my tray. A spatula. And then you want to preheat your oven to 180 degrees. And it takes about 20 to 30 minutes, normally about 25 I'd say is about ready. If you're using chocolate, obviously you can't really go on a golden brown colour, but it's down to your own preference really. If you cook them for a bit longer, they're a bit crispier. When I've added the bananas just then, that's when I would then grate in the chocolate if you haven't melted it in. Some people prefer to grate the chocolate in. I would do this just after you've added your bananas. It's entirely up to you. It doesn't make too much of a difference. Some people do like the little clumps of chocolate in the flapjack itself. It's up to you. And when you've cooked the flapjacks, score after about 10 minutes, let them cool, score out your markings of how you want the sizes to be for each flapjack, and then leave it for about another half an hour before you then use a spatula to hook them out. Put them on a griddle, a cooling rack I should say, and that's pretty much it. If you leave them for a couple of hours after you've taken them out of the oven, they do get a little bit crispier, some people like that, or if you can't resist the temptation, just eat them straight away. Your life, schwend.